Welcome, everybody. They say that music really soothes the soul. And the first time I heard Ronnie play, I felt like his music was reaching out and going into a place in my heart and my spirit that was really soothing and was really comforting. And as I got to know him over the years, and as I've watched him play, and as I've watched people play in his audience, I feel that he has a real gift. And his gift is that he can reach down deep inside his soul, and he really experiences emotions. And those emotions are very personal, and they're very universal as well. But his gift is that he can express those emotions through his music. And then that music comes up and it goes out to people in audiences and it touches their spirit and their hearts. And it takes them to places of healing and to places of hope and places of grace. And so I think that Ronnie Earl's music really speaks to people's souls. So it's my great pleasure to introduce to you tonight Ronnie Earl and the Broadcasters.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so very much. We're going to do one more for you and let you go home. Limina on the piano and the organ, Jimmy Mouradian on the bass, Lorne Entress on the drums. Thank you so much.
So we're going to get all the, I know it must be a little hot out there for you with all the lights.
So thank you very much.
You rock, Ronnie.
Thank you.
Ronnie, I know you've made a lot of musical friends over the years, and I'm sure some of your blues heroes have become your friends as well. Who are some of those people that you've had a chance to get to know?
Well, I feel very blessed about all that, because I got to become friends with and live amongst people like Coco Taylor, who helped me a great deal and in my youth, you know, and when I started out. I stayed at Robert Jr.'s house. We were very close. He cooked me fried chicken at 7 o'clock in the morning for breakfast. I was very dear friends with Earl King. And he was the best man at my wedding. I was very, very close with the original Fabulous Thunderbirds, especially Kim Wilson and Keith Ferguson and Jimmy Vaughan. I lived with all three of them for my time in Austin, Texas. I mentioned Big Walter. Big Walter, Eddie Cleanhead Vincent, John Rossi, the drummer for Roomful of Blues, was a very dear friend to me. And Eddie Cleanhead Vincent were the greatest geniuses that I got to play with. You know, some of them stayed at my mom and dad's house. Cotton did, and Witherspoon, and but you know, I used to hang out with Cleanhead, and it was just so wonderful.
Such precious memories, I'm sure, yeah, considering so many of those geniuses are gone, no longer with us. Your guitar playing as a guitarist is much more evolved than just a guitar style. I think you mentioned so many other players, harmonica players, singers, horn players. To develop your own style, you kind of rolled in a lot of different kinds of playing and different kinds of music, I think.
Yeah, well, you know, very early on, I'll tell you, I don't know if it's musical ignorance or anything, but I never was able to play anybody else's stuff. I just could not do it, you know, and that helped me. You know, maybe that was something from God. You know, I did listen to Otis Rush and Magic Sam and people like that. But somehow I developed my own style, because I always looked for the soul in music, not the technique, not the chops, not the, you know, but just like this wave of feeling that I got when I listened to Wayne Bennett, who was another dear friend of mine. This wave of feeling when I heard John Coltrane, and you know, and waves of feelings when I listened to Otis Spann, and you know, so I always went for the feeling, you know.
Ronnie, there's obviously a real spirituality in your playing and your approach to music. And once when we spoke, you said that there are levels of consciousness in your playing, and I meant to ask you what exactly you meant by that.
Well, you know, I think if you have, you know, in the 12-step programs, they you know, you learn about having divine intentions and good motives, and you know, I've realized through my wife that, you know, there are two worlds. There's the material world, there's the spiritual world. You know, the material world is the guitar magazines and the, you know, the awards and this and that, and I'm not saying any of that's bad, but it's not for me, you know, the fame thing. And what's important to me is moving people and healing and having love come through you, through whatever your higher power is, you know, for me not to be like a bad dude like I was, you know, 20 years ago, and but just to be as kind a person as I can be, and to pass it on to the younger generation. You know, we're going to have a younger guitarist on the CD, and you know, instead of bringing in all the stars on this DVD and CD, you know, we're having some people that are just very important to, you know, to pass it on, you know, because people were very loving and kind to me, and I feel very blessed. You know, Bob Margolin helped me a great deal. John Nicholas helped me, you know. They saw something in me. Duke Robillard was, you know, passed it on to me. So I want to be that channel too for the younger musicians, artists.
Do you see your life in different stages? You've overcome a lot of obstacles, physical obstacles, and now you were talking about the spirituality of the, you know, the music that's evolved to that. I take it, it didn't always start that way and reach that level of consciousness for you, did it? When you started, you weren't quite at that point, were you?
No, I had a big ego and low self-esteem, and because I was drinking and drugging, you know, for 18 years, and I thought I was a pretty cool dude, and really my playing didn't have, it was like gray. My playing was gray. It didn't have the sunlight. It didn't have, you know, power of higher power. And now everything feels clear, and I'm a clear channel. I think the audience feels that, and I'm with a beautiful band who has hung in there with me through my bouts of depression, and you know, I've been clean and sober for 18 years, so you know, it's things are a day at a time, and you know, I have good days and sometimes better days, sometimes days are hard, but we're really trying to come out and play more now. I mean, I know I'm not going to be touring this year or anything, but who knows what might happen. My drummer, producer, Lorne, is always telling me, we should go to Chicago, so maybe I'll make him happy with that sometime.
I think that's one of the reasons why you wanted to do this DVD, is
right,
because you really haven't traveled very much or
no,
played too often, really.
No, no, but I did for 25 years, you know. I feel like I gave everything I had to the world, you know, for 25 years while other people stayed home and raised families, and, you know, I don't have any children, but when I came down with diabetes, and I just said, you know, I need some time to heal and think about music and think about how I can be the best human being I can be, you know.
I know you've been contributing to your own community that way too. You give some guitar lessons, you work with younger people.
Yeah. And you know, I also can't stress the importance of the band that I'm with. They're really all beautiful people and very supportive of me. And, you know, we don't work very much sometimes, you know, and they've all hung in there with me. So I know that they're feeling this spiritual thing too. We're all together as a family, that they keep coming back to wanting to do this music.
Is there anything else you'd like to say?
Very importantly, I'd like to say that if you're watching this anywhere, that you don't have to live a life of drinking and drugging to be an artist. You know, you don't have to kill yourself with that stuff. You can have a good life, you know. It's there for you. And there's room in the world for as much art, you know, as the world, you know, there's always room for another great artist. And I think it's all the guys that are playing in basements, playing the blues in basements or whatever, we're all just as important. We're all beautiful children of God.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let's see. I'm going to play a little gospel tune, you know, see if I can remember it.